Mastitis is an inflammation of the breast. Mastitis is associated with breastfeeding period. Symptoms usually occur suddenly and characterized breast tenderness or warmth to the touch, swelling of the breast, pain or a burning sensation in the breast. Sometimes fever and general soreness. Sometimes shivering and chills also occurs. Mastitis usually develops in one breast. Complications can include abscess formation, which represents collection of pus. About 10% of breastfeeding women has mastitis. It means it's quite a common disease. Mastitis usually occur within first few weeks after delivery. Causes. Mastitis typically develops when the milk is not properly removed from the breast. Milk duct block. Tight-fitting clothing or an over-restrictive bra also risk factors for developing mastitis and infection. Mastitis may also develop when the baby has infrequent feeds or has problems suckling the milk out of the breast. Cracks or sores on the nipples increases the likelihood of infection. So, mastitis may be infective or non-infective inflammation of breast tissue. Approximately 15% will require antibiotic treatment for infection. Lactational or puerperal mastitis is the inflammation of the breast in connection with pregnancy or breastfeeding. In rare cases, mastitis may develop non-breastfeeding women. It is called non-puerperal mastitis. It may can occur even in men. Inflammatory breast cancer has symptoms very similar to mastitis and must be ruled out. The diagnosis of mastitis and breast abscess can usually be made based on a physical examination. If mass presence is in the breast, it may be abscess or a tumor. A breast ultrasound may be performed to rule out any cancer. Treatment. In lactation mastitis, frequent emptying of both breasts by breastfeeding is essential. Also essential is adequate fluid supply for the mother and baby. For breastfeeding women with light mastitis, massage and application of heat prior to feeding can help, as this may aid unblocking the ducts. However, in more severe cases of mastitis, heat or massage could make the symptoms worse, and cold compresses are better suited to contain the inflammation. Non-puerperal mastitis may be treated with medications, aspiration or drainage. Antibiotics are generally to be used in all non-puerperal mastitis cases. If there is fungal infection, then antifungal medication. Corticosteroids are used for granulomatous mastitis. Dicloxacillin or cefalexin are recommended antibiotics. For severe cases, vancomycin is recommended. The length of antibiotic treatment ranges from 5 to 14 days.